In Luke chapter 7, there's a great story, and it's a story about the kind of faith that not only gets God's attention, but impresses him. And it's the story of this Roman officer. He is a centurion, which is a really cool name, in the Roman army. And he has a slave who is about to die. He hears about Jesus. He hears that Jesus is coming to town. So he sends some people with a message. And he sends this message to Jesus and says, please, you know, my servant, my slave is sick. Can you please do something? So Jesus takes off and he's going with these people to go to the centurion's house to heal his servant. And that's where we catch up the story. And it's verse 6 in chapter 7. And it says this. So Jesus accompanied them. When they approached the centurion's home, the centurion sent out some friends to bring a message to Jesus. And the message was this: Lord, don't go to the trouble of coming inside. I'm not worthy to have you come under my roof. That's why I sent others with my request. Just say the word, and that will be enough to heal my servant. I understand how authority works, being under authority myself and having soldiers under my authority. I command to one, go, and he goes. I say to another, come, and he comes. I say to my slave, do this, and he obeys me. Jesus was deeply impressed when he heard this. He turned to the crowd that followed him and he said this: listen, everyone, this outsider, this Roman, has more faith than I have found even among our own Jewish people. The friends of the centurion returned home and they found that the slave was completely healed. Not only did he get Jesus' attention with his faith, but he impressed him. He had some really impressive faith. Jesus turns around and he's like, I haven't seen greater faith than this in all Israel. And when Jesus says all Israel, he's not just talking about the context in which he lived on this planet. I mean, he has seen all Israel. He's been around since the creation. He's been around forever. So he's seen Moses. He has seen Noah. He's seen Abraham. He's seen all these guys. So he's saying, I haven't seen faith in anyone greater than this. This is an amazing example of faith because it combined a couple of things. It combined a complete compassion for someone else, and then it combined complete trust in the authority of Jesus. Woo! This was totally unselfish faith. This wasn't a personal request. The centurion wasn't like, yeah, Jesus, I just need your help. I need a little money, or I need this, or I need to get out of this jam. It was a totally unselfish request. This was compassion for someone else. His slave was sick, and his slave was about to die. So it's a complete compassion for someone else. And then it's complete trust in the authority of Jesus. He's saying, just say the word and that will be enough. Just say it, because I get this authority thing. I'm under authority myself. People are under my authority. I know how it works. If I say something needs to be done, it gets done. And so he's got this complete trust in the fact that God has all authority. Don't miss out on what God is doing. Don't miss out on what Jesus is doing by being selfish or by not trusting him. Realize this, all right? The faith that gets God's attention, the faith that really impresses him, is the kind of faith that shows complete compassion for people around us. And it shows a complete trust in his authority. That doesn't mean a complete understanding. That doesn't mean we know everything, but we're willing to trust and we're willing to say, I know how this authority thing works. So Jesus, just say the word and that will be enough. This situation over here, it needs hope, it needs healing. So just say the word, Jesus, because I know that that will be enough. That's the kind of faith that impresses Jesus. God bless you guys. Giddy up.